you so much for watching Miss Angel League TV, where we talk about everything, and when I mean everything, I mean like. As y'all can see by the title, we are on episode number 7, and if this is your first time watching my videos and y'all like, what she talking about, I'm doing a whole series, so stop this video and go look at the other 6 videos before this, because this is a whole series, so you need to know the breakdown, because it's a lot, girl. So go ahead and do that. Also, if you have not done so already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below, because you don't want to miss my next story time. You know I post these videos every Friday at 6 p.m. And also, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button so everyone can know who your girl is. And last but not least, hit that notification bell. That way you can be notified whenever I post. So other than that, I ain't gonna talk too long. We're just gonna go ahead and get right into the story time. So last story time was a somewhat victory, because Katrina got her baby back. After 6 whole months, she finally got her baby back, and I was really, really happy for her, y'all. And I was just like, okay, this is just new beginnings, you know. So time starts going on, and Katrina immediately knew she was gonna need, like, to either put the baby in daycare, because at this point she was working overnight. It was like 2 days out the week that she was gonna need someone to watch the baby, and I already got a lot going on. She already knew not to ask me. Yeah, I'm home because I work from home, but I'm also working from home and taking care of my little ones at the same time. So me and my husband was not signing up for that. Like, yeah, we were grateful that she had her baby back, but we were not signing up to be nobody babysitter. So Katrina decided to put her in daycare 2 times a week. Now, it was like $150 a week, I believe. The plan was for me to bring the baby to daycare on Thursdays and Fridays. So on Thursday and Friday mornings, before I go to work, I would bring the baby to daycare. And then on Katrina's way home from work, which is typically about like noon-ish, she'll go pick up the baby and then bring her home. So that was the little schedule, whatever. And it worked out for a while. Katrina, she couldn't afford it like by herself. Her mom did help her. I think they were like going half and half or something like that. I don't know exactly what the arrangement was, but whatever it was, her mama did help her. Obviously Darius wasn't helping at this point. Her and Darius wasn't even talking at this point. She was just doing things on her own, just trying to figure it out. And I commend her, like she did that, you know. She did what she had to do, got things in order for her baby to come home and so forth. Now, one thing I'm gonna mention, this situation is gonna come back up later on throughout this story time, but we noticed Katrina was having a little issues disciplining her son, Steven, and Lil Dante. Steven, he was becoming a teenager at this point. He was like 13, going on 14. Katrina, she was more so in the habit of going to work at night. Her son would get up for school. He had an alarm, so he would get himself up for school because he was the first one to go to school, since the other children went to a different school at the time. And so I would get up the little kids to go to school and get on the bus, which would include little Dante, because little Dante and my son Santiago, they are a year apart. Little Dante, at this point, well, shit, I don't fucking remember how old they were at this point, but just know they were a year apart, so they were in the same grade level. Or not the same grade, but in the same school. I would get her child up. She would come home from work, like I say, about 12 noon or whatever, come take a nap or whatever, sleep. But that became like her routine on a daily. She didn't really too much interact with her children. Most times she was like honestly sleep throughout the day, because I guess she was working. I can't really say because you know, as a parent, rather you work overnight or not, like you still gotta be up and tend to your children and make sure everything good for the next day, you know, just prepare your children for the next day and just be a parent. But she did take the little sleeping a little overboard at this point, but we didn't really care too much because it wasn't affecting us. Like, we, you know, she was still paying her bills. It was what it was. Those weren't our kids, they were her kids, so whatever. Maybe about a month or so later, her and Darius started talking, like communicating via phone. And come to find out, girl, Darius had moved to the doggone Georgia at this point. Supposedly he moved to Georgia for a better job, but it really wasn't that. If you know Darius, you know Darius would run away. The first thing Darius is gonna always try to do is run away from his problems. So it wasn't a surprise to us that he just all of a sudden moved to Georgia. And he didn't like move to Georgia like blindly. He does have family out there in Georgia, so he moved in with his brother. I was like, oh, okay, like, good for him. You know, I didn't give a fuck. Long as he wasn't bothering me and disrupting my life, I'm still low-key bitter about the fact that I had to pay his part of the rent and her part of the rent because he wanted to up and move, but whatever. But yeah, I knew this obviously because Katrina would tell me. And so she was like, yeah, he said he moved out there to find a better job. She would like exchange photos with him with the baby and every so often FaceTime with the baby. All of the things that she's doing, he didn't really give her the opportunity to do. Like there were maybe a handful of times that he allowed her to FaceTime the baby, but it really wasn't that much. I'm just saying this to say like she's not being nasty with him or anything like that. She's actually being cordial with him. A typical baby mama would probably try to do a tiff attack type of thing, but she wasn't doing it. Darius and Katrina also decided to like not do anything with the courts, don't have the courts involved. They were supposed to, like I told y'all in the last story time, they were supposed to follow up with another court date to kind of establish paternity and stuff, because technically Darius legally was not the father of the baby. And also I think Katrina, her lawyer, wanted like a couple extra $1,000 just to move forward with the next step, and I don't think she really gave a fuck about it at this point. She was just on the type where like, shit, I got my baby back, so that's the only thing that really mattered to me. So if he wanna establish paternity, if he wanna do this, he wanna do that, then he'll take me to court and it'll be that. But Darius at this point wasn't even speaking with his lawyer anymore because he had moved to fucking Georgia, bitch. Like, what is he gonna do out there in Georgia? Absolutely nothing, right? So everything was just like put to a pause. They didn't show up to court, they ignored letters, and nobody knew nothing. It was just like nothing happened. So they basically did all of that, you know, just to like do absolutely nothing. Summer of 2021, girl, June to be exact, of 2021, Darius decided he was gonna come down to see the baby. So he was gonna drive down from Georgia to Houston to see the baby, since he hadn't seen the baby in a couple of months, which at this point would have been like, what, 2 or 3 months. So the plan was for him to come. And then also at this point, his brother and his family, the brother that he was living with in Georgia, yeah, that family, they were all also coming down here to Houston as well just to visit, right? So that was like a perfect time for Darius to really come out here anyways, because they were coming out here at the same time. So, you know, it just only made sense. I don't know exactly how Katrina brought this up to us, but she was just basically like, hey, Darius wants to come and see the baby, but I'm not comfortable with, like, you know, bringing her to him or, you know, letting him pick her up or anything. So like, is it okay if Darius comes over with the baby? And so we like, I mean, yeah, that's fine, that's cool or whatever. And then also Darius's brother and his family and kids and stuff were also gonna come by to see us and see Gabriel and stuff like that as well. So it was like a win-win situation. Also at that time, the mother-in-law and the sister, they all decided to go with Darius as well, because no one has seen the baby since April. They missed the baby and wanted to see the baby too, so everyone thought it was a great idea to come to my house and have a big fucking reunion. I guess this was on a Saturday. I was working, you know, I work from home. I work downstairs, like literally I worked right in front of the kitchen in like the dining room area, not too far from the living room, which ultimately everyone was sitting at in the living room. So I'm working, doing my thing, y'all. Everyone starts coming in the house and they know I'm working, so they're being quiet, they're not being loud or anything like that. It's a bunch of people. It's Darius' brother, Darius' brother, two kids, it's Darius' brother's wife, it's Darius' mom, Darius' sister, Darius' sister's husband, Darius' sister's kids, which is like three of them. Girl, it was a bunch of people. And like, now that I'm saying it out loud, I'm like, why did everybody have to do that? Like, y'all did not have to all come to my house to see one baby. But it was all good, no bad blood, no one was mad at one another or anything, so it wasn't like weird that everyone was coming. Even weird to me, I was just like, long as Darius ain't on that bullshit and he come to see his baby, like, that's it. I'm all for a father having a relationship with their child, you know, by any means. So I was not gonna tell her, oh no, he can't come step foot in our house, even though probably we should have said that. But being the good people that we are, we was just like, yeah, go ahead and do your thing, whatever. So Gabriel, he was in the room as everybody came to the house, and I was downstairs working. I forgot to mention, one of Darius' homegirls came with him as well. One of the homegirls that he used to live, like back in story time number two, I think, whenever he got evicted and he was living with a friend. Yeah, her, that homegirl, came to the house with him as well. So everybody all crowded up in our living room, seeing the baby, and, oh, you know, she's so cute, da da da. You know, just typical shit. To be honest, I don't know how this next situation even came about, because I was working. I just kind of started to hear like the end of it, sort of. But I just remember hearing Darius just started talking shit to his homegirl, the homegirl that I just was telling you about. He was just talking shit to his homegirl. I really wish I knew what he said about Katrina, but whatever it was, I don't remember. But whatever it was enough for me to text my husband. So I'm still at my desk working. Like, he don't know that I'm listening to him, like, basically talk shit at Katrina. And Katrina, she's the type, like, she's real passive. Like, she's you know, she's gonna kind of like try to brush it off or whatever, kind of laugh it off. So she wasn't really saying anything. Whatever it was he was saying to her, she wasn't, or at her, I don't think he was talking to her. You know, when somebody being like messy, they and they know you right there, and they want you to hear what they saying. He was on that type of shit, right? I remember texting my husband, and I'm just like, I think you might need to come down here, because Darius being real childish and being real petty with Katrina, and she ain't saying nothing. So I just think you should just come down here and make sure everything good, and you know, just kind of make sure everything all right, because you know, I'm over here working, right? So I ain't got time to be doing all of that and making sure everybody good, and you know what I'm saying, ain't arguing. I don't have time for that. I'm working. So I told my husband to do that. So my husband came downstairs and was talking to everybody else, you know, not Darius per se, but you know, Darius' mom and Darius' brother. Like, he was just communicating with them and stuff, chopping it up cool, right? And whatever it was that I can't remember that Darius was doing or saying, he started to do it again in front of my husband. And so at this point, my husband is seeing what I'm telling him that he's like doing, and so my husband ends up mentioning to him like, hey, like, you need to chill out, like, don't do all of that up in here, like, we're not about to have all of that. I don't know what Darius said, but whatever it was that Darius said in response to my husband, it was loud as fuck. I said, oh, let me take these headsets off. I went into, I don't know what status I went into, bitch, but I went in some damn status that I wasn't supposed to be in at work. And I got my ass the fuck up and stood next to my husband, and I'm like, what's going on? This is me talking to Darius. I said, I'm over here working and you being loud. Like, what's the problem? I don't remember what he said to me. Whatever it was, I said, again, you're being loud. You're being loud, and I'm just letting you know I'm working. You know I work from home, so I would appreciate if you would lower your tone up in here. He said something else that I didn't like. And I told him, you can get out my house, because I'm over here working and you still doing all that extra shit. We're not doing that over here. You came over here to see your child, and that's what it was supposed to be. Nothing more, nothing less. But now you're being disrespectful, so now you can walk up on my house. He gets up and starts talking shit. At this point, Gabriel and him is going back and forth. To this day, I don't know how or why my husband went from being on the side of me to being in front Darius, as in front the door, as if he was getting ready to open the door for him. But I knew he wasn't getting ready to open the door for him, because somebody else was standing in front the door, so they could have easily opened the door for him. I don't know, bitch, this shit happened so fucking fast. This whole story, or this situation that I'm getting ready to tell y'all, probably was like a 45 minute type of thing, but to me, in my mind, honestly, I can only remember it like 60 seconds worth, because it just happened so fast, bitch. I don't remember who threw the first lick. I don't remember. I'm gonna have to ask my husband. I'm gonna probably ask my husband while I'm editing this, so if I can remember to ask him, I'm gonna put it right here. But whoever threw the first lick, and bitch, they just started motherfucking fighting. I'm like, bitch, I know you motherfucking lying. We got the whole family here. We got the kids up in here. They start fucking fist fighting, bitch. The kids are on the stairs at this point. As soon as we notice or realize they started fighting, we told the kids, y'all go upstairs, go upstairs, go upstairs. I'm telling my husband, I'm like, stop, stop. Like, this isn't just me. I'm just constantly saying stop, stop, stop. And so at one point, Darius had a fanny pack on. Well, he came in the house, rather, with a fanny pack on. And I had never seen Darius with a fanny pack a day in my life. He starts to reach inside of the fanny pack and take the fanny pack off. And then all of a sudden, I see Darius' mom, like, go to him and try to take it. Like, whatever it was, he was finna pull out that fanny pack, which I'm gonna tell y'all what it is in a second. But whatever it was that he was getting ready to pull out that fanny pack, the mama, she hurried up and grabbed it as if she knew what was in it. He almost was like playing tug of war with it, and then at some point he just gave up. Between myself and my husband, it instantly clicked this nigga was getting ready to pull out a motherfucking weapon. More than likely a gun. This nigga was getting ready to pull out a gun. And so, you know what my husband did? I'm so tired of this damn gun. I think this gun has made its second appearance in the story time series. We barely halfway there yet. His gun was in his car, right? He goes to the damn car, gets his gun, and he like, what's up? What you got up in there? What you was trying to do? Somehow, the gun ends up on the couch. I don't know who took it from him. I don't know if my husband just put the gun down at some point whenever he realized that Darius no longer had any weapon in his hand or was no longer trying to reach for whatever he was trying to reach for. So at this point, they fighting on the motherfucking couch, bitch. And so now I'm getting in the middle of it because I'm like, y'all not about to be fighting in my house. Like, that's what we not gonna do. So I'm literally trying to break it up physically. My little old ass, bitch. And I'll never do that again. Well, no, I ain't gonna say I'll never do that again because, bitch, if my husband fighting, it's easy. I'm gonna jump your ass with my husband or I'm gonna try to break it up. So I'm pretty sure you're gonna rather me try to break it up, so that it is what it is. But yeah, girl, I'm pulling him and shit. I'm like, babe, stop, because at this point my husband is on top of Darius and he literally like punching him dead in his fucking face. So as I'm seeing him giving him these blows to the face, dead in the face, like up close and personal to the fucking face, I grab my husband's elbow, like I pull his elbow back because I'm like, babe, stop hitting him, because I was just like, damn, like you hitting him enough, like you didn't hit him enough now, like okay, you can stop, go ahead and get off, y'all could be done fighting now, it's over with, it's done, girl. So they get up. If y'all could hear the breathing, my husband breathing hard, bitch, and Darius breathing hard, bitch, they the same motherfucking size, bitch. At this point, everybody almost close to 30. Y'all two motherfucking ugly, y'all doing all this fighting. I'm just gonna say that. But hey, Darius and my husband, that's what they do. Like I told y'all, they grew up together, they've had multiple fights. That was normal to them. Wasn't normal for me because I don't do all of that. Like I don't get down like that at all. Y'all already know I've only had one fight in my life, and that was me fighting my mama, unfortunately. 21 year old fighting a 40 something year old woman. That was the only time I ever got in a fight. Y'all already know that story time. If you know, you know. If you don't, go look for it. It's in there. It's in there. Just look for it. I promise that story time is in there. They breathing hard and shit. Harder than a motherfucker, bitch. Huffing and damn puffing because they motherfucking tired. I know they tired. They too old for that shit. I know they tired. Bitch, I'm tired because I'm tired of trying to break the shit up. So they stop fighting again. Mind you, this is the second round, right? So all of a sudden, bitch, I see Darius walk to my goddamn kitchen and pull it through my drawers and stuff like he trying to look for a knife or something. And I say, what the fuck are you doing? He's pulling the drawers out, but he's not pulling anything like or taking anything out. And so after I see him pull the drawers, he looking in the cabinets, bitch. Why the fuck this nigga grab my griddle? And if you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm gonna put a picture up here. My brand new griddle that I just bought. He grabbed my fucking griddle. I said, what the fuck is you doing? Give me this shit. The first thing I'm thinking in my mind, like, you about to try to hit my husband upside his head with a fucking griddle. In my house, in front of me, nah, that's not happening. My little old ass. Okay, at this point, I'm probably with a good maybe 105, all right? And at this point, Darius is probably a good 215, bitch. 215, 220, something like that. Bitch, I grabbed that motherfucking griddle. My hands acted as if they were the jaws of life at this point, because bitch, when I say I grabbed that damn griddle, and I grabbed that griddle so motherfucking tight, bitch, and I pulled that shit with all my motherfucking might, that griddle slipped out his hand like butter, bitch. I was surprised and shocked at myself that day, because I said, I just overpowered this grown ass man because he had me and my husband fucked up. That's how you know I don't play with my husband, because bitch, I ain't got no strength. I don't work out. I don't do none of that shit. But baby, that day, I felt like somebody's superhero because he just had me fucked up. And no, you're not about to grab my shit and think that you finna do something to my husband in front. Nah. After I pulled the griddle from Darius' hands, he had the nerve to grab the fucking toaster and drop it on the ground. And I'm just like, what the fuck is wrong with you? He talking about something, that's my toaster. And bitch, it was. Bitch, it was his toaster. It was his toaster that he left and never, you know. But bitch, what the fuck is you gonna do with a toaster? And you just got a place to lay your head. You just got a pot to piss in. But okay, I'm gonna let you have that. You wanted to feel like you was doing something. So I'm gonna let you have your little toaster that you just slammed on the ground and did absolutely nothing with. Long as you knew you was not finna knock my husband upside his head because you felt some type of way because you got your shit the fuck knocked in. I mean, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. You should have kept your mouth closed when I told your ass to shut your ass up whenever I was working, but she didn't do that, so it escalated. Darius walks out the house, bitch, and so everybody's still in the house, like the family and everything. They well, no, I'm lying. The mama and the brother, they were outside, like, I guess, talking to Darius or whatever, and they eventually came inside. But at this point, while they're still out there with them, bitch, I'm all out of breath. My damn kitchen got toaster parts on the damn ground. Oh, and they also put a hole in my wall, because whenever they started fighting closer to the door, you know how the door hit the wall, because if you push it too hard, they put a goddamn hole in my wall right here. The mama finally came back inside, the sister and everybody, we just sitting in my living room, just all looking at each other. Even Katrina, we all looking at each other. Well, Katrina, she looking dumbfounded, like, oh my god, I didn't mean for this to happen. This is your baby daddy. This is your motherfucking baby daddy. I don't know what to say. Once again, another disaster, another fight. I've given up hope, because I'm just like, we can never have like peace whenever it comes to this nigga. Like, I'm just not understanding what is wrong with him. And then, bitch, it get worse. We go outside, motherfucking laws pull up, bitch. I'm like, okay, I ain't surprised, but I noticed Darius' car was parked like way at the end of my street, but I could still see it like visually. I seen like a random girl pull up to his car and was talking to him as the officers was talking to Gabriel, because which is my husband was talking to officers and giving them like his part or whatever, and just, it's the same old shit like I in story time one, child, when they got into that first fight. Well, the first fight in front of me, because they, like I said, they fought other times before I came in the picture. That's just what the fuck they do. But bitch, I don't get down like that. We don't want to do all that shit. I'm tired of drama. I just want to live peaceful. So everybody outside just, you know, waiting to see what's gonna go down, because the police get called. Initially, we didn't know who called the police. Once my husband got to talking to the police officer, you know, the police officer obviously told him, like, you know, Darius called and told us that you pulled a gun on him. Same old sob story again. I bet he ain't say nothing about what the fuck he tried to pull out that fanny pack, though. He ain't say shit about that fanny pack. But okay, then go off, because guess what, it don't even fucking matter whenever I get to ready to tell y'all what I'm getting ready to tell y'all. Police end up coming in the house to see the scene or whatever. The police ends up looking at my husband's gun, making sure it was registered to him and wasn't stolen. Same protocol that they have to do in episode number one. After they did a little investigation or whatever, they was explaining to my husband that Darius was the one that called. They asked my husband if he wanted to press charges, because technically, like, Darius was not living there, so, like, he was a disturbance to our peace, bitch. Like, you came to our house with that bullshit, like, the fuck? But didn't have the nerve to call the cops after you started the shit, after you couldn't just lower your motherfucking tone in my house? How you call the police on yourself? But we gonna get to it, because it gets worse. Hold on. After all of that goes down, my husband tells the police officer, like, nah, I'm not trying to press charges or whatever. I didn't even know the laws was gonna get called. Like, it was just gonna be another typical fight, and I was gonna go on about my day. But I see that he wanna get the laws involved or whatever, which is cool, because he trying to, for whatever reason, he just wanted my husband to get in trouble so bad. My husband was not in the wrong. He was just defending himself. So some time go by, and then officers go back and talk to my husband again and say, look, Darius is gonna be coming with us. We're not like arresting him on anything pertaining to this, but he got warrants, and so we're gonna be taking him with us. He'll probably be out by Monday or whatever, but we'll just let you know that he's gonna be coming with us, and we let him know that he's not no longer welcome to y'all house to come back, because my husband told them that he didn't want him to come back. Basically, if he came back, he would be like trespassing, basically, right? When my husband told me that he was getting ready to go to jail because he had warrants, I said, I know you motherfucking lying. How are you going to cause drama in someone else's household, call the cops, play victim, and then you got warrants? Girl, the donkey of the day goes to Darius. You played yourself, for real. I was done laughing in the inside, because I'm just like, boy, you dumb. You dumb as hell. But okay, like, at least we ain't gotta worry about you for a little weekend or whatever. You could've just stayed your ass in Georgia if it was gonna be all of that. Girl, that shit was just crazy to me. It was crazy as hell to me, because he really just, I just knew Darius just knew he had him. Darius like, oh, I got him. Nah, I got his ass. I'm calling the cops on his ass again. This is your second time calling the cops on my husband. The first time you ran off, and the first time you ran off was probably because you knew your ass had warrants and you wasn't ready to go to jail. But then the second time you were like, fuck it, I'm gonna be bold this time, and I'm gonna stay my ass right here. I'm gonna stay my ass right the fuck here and go to jail. While all of this happening, Katrina's still looking dumb as hell. I wasn't mad at her because I'm pretty sure she didn't know that was gonna happen, but she was looking dumb as hell though. She was definitely looking stupid as hell because, like, what can you say? You wanted a baby with this man so bad. You welcome. Oh girl, then the next day we ended up going to San Antonio, taking the kids to SeaWorld Child. Well, that was already planned anyway. Went on about our day like nothing fucking happened while Darius was still in jail for the weekend. I said that to say, I know y'all be saying in the comments like, oh, that story time seems so short. Look, it's been gone for 2 years, okay? I bet you got 7 kids. It's hard out here with these 50-minute video. I have to watch my video essentially 3 times. My editing process, it goes through a whole thing. Like, I'm just to let y'all know, it ain't just edit, boom, clack, put it on YouTube. It ain't that. So I'm sorry if y'all were expecting the story time to be longer, but this is all I have for this story time, because next story time we gonna get into the main character. I know we've been talking about Darius a lot, but to be quite honest, the main character is Katrina. Mm-hmm. It is. And we're going to get into a little bit more about her in these next story times. Probably from this story time and out, going to be mainly about her. Okay? So we can say toodaloos to Darius for a little minute because we're going to get into her business. We already in her mind chart. So on that note, I'm going to end this video here. I love y'all so much. If you like this video and you know you haven't subscribed like you should have did in the beginning, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. That way you can keep up and be a part of the family, okay? Also, hit that notification bell. And I need to see some thumbs up as well. Let me say this right now, so I'll give y'all a heads up. After this next story time, we're going to take a little break. Just a 2-week break on the series. Maybe 1 week, but I'm thinking maybe 2 weeks. I don't know. I'm going to figure it out. But that don't mean y'all not going to see me. We still going to have videos posting in the meantime. So let me know what videos y'all want to see. Next week I have the whole week off, so I'm gonna be planning some content and stuff like that. So I just want to know what y'all want to see. Like, let me know. I need that feedback, that way I can keep these videos coming to y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to follow me on all of my social medias, that way you can keep up with my real life as well outside of YouTube. And I'm gonna see y'all in my next video. Bye.